Hello everyone and welcome to New Tech Tuesday Tutorials. My name is Richard Evans. Make sure that you like, comment, and subscribe. Now today I would like to show you how to control the Previz function of the TriCaster with a control panel. So Previz allows you to previsualize a composition for either your program row or your mix effects without having to overwrite any of the current settings. A virtual sandbox for you to play around in and create something cool. So you can also use pre-existing configurations and copy them into Previz to make changes, then paste from Previz into your mix effects or program with just a few keystrokes. Using the control surface gives you a physical control of this and makes setting up your shots extremely easy. So let's dive in and take a look. All right, so I'm gonna start off in the TriCaster TC1 interface, and I currently have mix effect number 2 punched up on my program output right now. And the configuration that I currently have of mix effect number 2 is I have a quad box going on here using my 4-layered set, and then I've positioned my different inputs in certain sections of the screen so that I can have them all lined up nice and pretty here. And if, as you've seen in previous videos, it's been kind of a struggle for me to go through and set up a quad box looking nice and perfect. Just to get everything lined up can kind of be a pain. So what I want to do, let's say that in my particular broadcast that I'm going to do today, is I want to have my mix effect number 2 set up to be where I have my inputs 2, 3, 4, and 5 as my different inputs on this particular mix effect. But let's say I want another shot that's using the same positioning of that mix effect, but with different inputs in it. So the easiest way to do that, and that way I can switch between them and use them however I want. And the easiest way to do that is to send those particular configurations over to Previz so I can pre-visualize what that shot's gonna look like. All right, and then I can copy it from there, do some adjustments, and then go ahead and paste it somewhere else, like for example, mix effect number 3. Okay, so to do that, let's go ahead and move over to my control panel and show you how to do that. So here's our control panel here. Now the first thing that I want to do is I'm going to leave my bottom stripe doing my regular old show here, and then I want to have my top stripe control what I'm going to be sending to Previz. All right, so to do that, I'll hold down Delegate Stripe and select Mix Effect number 2. All right, that's good to go, and now you'll see that I have Mix Effect number 2 over here, and then I have my different shots layered up however I need to here. All right, so now what I'm gonna do is I'm going to copy the settings from mix effect number 2 and throw them over to Previz. And to do that, looking on the control panel, you'll see that I have an option right here. It's also down here as well, depending if you wanna do this for your main mixer or if you wanna just have your bottom stripe be a different mix effect, however you wanna do it here. You can assign those via here or up here. And I'm going to do it up here just because that's the way that my particular workflow, that's how I like to do it. All right, so I'm going to copy this over to Previz by clicking 2. So this will send those settings to Previz. And let's go ahead and click that. And if we look back over on the interface, now you'll see that Previz is set up with my particular shot layout already done. So now what I want to do is I'm going to say Delegate Stripe, and now let's select Previz. All right, and now Previz is up here for me to go through and start to mess around with. All right, so now what I want to do is I want to have my layer A, the top layer here, let's make that a completely different input. So I'm just going to switch things around to have a different show going on here. So I'm going to select on my layer A, let's do input number 3. And for layer B, let's do input number 4. And let's go ahead and I'm going to move over to my C layer here. So I'll click C. And now I can select 5 for that. And let's go to layer D by clicking D here. And that will assign the bottom row to D. And let's select input 7. So this will be my guy on bike. All right, so now that is lined up and it's pretty much good to go. So now what I wanna do is copy the settings from Previz and send them over to mix effect number 3. So let's go ahead and I'm gonna say Delegate Stripe, click on Delegate Stripe, click mix effect number 3, All right, and now I'm on mix effect number 3, and on the interface right now there is nothing there. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to paste from Previz to mix effect 3 simply by clicking on from on our Previz option here. And check this out. Let's go ahead and do that. Hit from. And now you'll see that I have the settings that were on Previz now pasted over into mix effects number 3. So now I can go through on my switcher and let's go pull up mix effect number 3 on my preview here. And now I can then swap between those shots and use them just as I would a normal, regular, everyday show. So a really good way for you to have a tactile feel and use your control panel to its fullest ability and use Previz to play around with different settings and change different mix effects without having to go through and destroy a mix effect that you're working on. And again, you can use this for both your mix effects or your main switcher. It's kind of up to you. Just get in there, start pushing some buttons, and have some fun. So, as you can see, using a control panel to control your Previz is super useful. Now, if you'd like this video and would like to see similar tutorial videos on new tech products, click subscribe on the New Tech YouTube channel at youtube.com/newtechinc. For formal training on new tech products, you can sign up for New Tech University, which is available at newtech.com/newtech-u. For more information on new tech products and services, contact your local reseller or visit our website, newtech.com. And lastly, if you are sharing your work on social media using new tech products, tag us using the hashtags NewTech or TriCaster. We'd love to see what y'all are up to. That's all for this episode. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time for another edition of New Tech Tuesday Tutorials.